352 will first remove and eat the limbs of her prey to prevent it from wandering away, and then take several days to fully devour the rest of it. Humans have been observed to still be in a euphoric state and have no knowledge of the outside world, even as they suffer the loss of limbs and other bodily tissue. Hello everybody, I'm The Rubber. Today, we bring you SCP Foundation Keter Class Object SCP-352. SCP-352, also known as Baba Yaga, appears to be an incredibly old, emaciated woman of indeterminate age and race. 352 speaks Old Russian, but with an accent and dialect that makes it even harder to understand and translate. 352 usually does not converse with any of the members of the SCP Foundation, but when she does, her words come off as threats of revenge or bodily harm. 352 has never identified herself by any name, and due to her aggressive nature, it has been impossible to determine any background information. SCP-352 possesses a level of strength and speed much higher than what should be possible for a person of her perceived age and physical dimensions, and has been shown moving loads in excess of 200 kilograms with little physical strain, and moving at speeds in excess of 70 kilometers per hour. 352 can recover from wounds that would be lethal to a human being, including decapitation and disemboweling. This regeneration can take between several days to several weeks, depending on severity. Internally, 352 appears to be a normal human woman, with muscles, bones, and organs in a state consistent with her advanced age. SCP-352 is capable of growing very thin, hair-like strands from any part of her body, apparently at will. These strands can grow several meters in an hour and appear to be at least partially under the control of 352. They have been observed crawling along floors and up walls and other structures. These hairs are clear and nearly invisible to the naked eye and appear to be slightly weaker than standard human hair. The strands are also coated in a thin layer of chemical enzyme identical to the enzyme in the saliva of 352. SCP-352 produces an enzyme that is most concentrated in the saliva and hair, but is present in all bodily tissues of 352. How it is produced and its exact chemical makeup are unknown. This enzyme reacts when contact with human tissue and rapidly attacks the nervous system. Anyone who comes into contact with the enzyme will experience symptoms almost immediately, which include hallucinations, euphoria, suppression of cognitive or logical thinking, and suppression of pain receptors. This state will persist for several days if the exposure to the enzyme is mild and can become permanent with high exposure. Unfortunately, bites from 352 will lead to high exposure in 99.9% of cases. SCP-352 appears to subsist on a carnivorous diet with a strong preference for human flesh. 352 will create a web of hair and wait for prey to become exposed to the enzyme and become more docile. Once she has her prey within her grasp, 352 will first remove and eat the limbs of her prey to prevent it from wandering away, and then take several days to fully devour the rest of it. Humans have been observed to still be in a euphoric state and have no knowledge of the outside world, even as they suffer the loss of limbs and other bodily tissue. SCP-352 prefers any type of human flesh over any other type of meat. While 352 kills and eats any human that she comes across, she prefers to feed on children between the ages of 0 to 2. After observation of 352 highly elevated levels of cooperation and a reduced tendency to attack staff while consuming flesh of this type, a possible alteration in the current diet is being considered. Personnel who works at 352's containment site requested the use of SCP-604 and SCP-1680 as a more efficient food source for 352. SCP-604 is a set of tableware and dishes. Some are studded with diamonds and rubies, and some are made from fine materials such as porcelain and crystal. Whenever an edible solid is placed onto one of the plates or a liquid is poured into one of the drink vessels, the food will transform into human flesh, or the nearest equivalent organ, body part, or fluid. For example, fleshy steaks will turn into cuts from the thigh, and red wine or juices into human blood. If 604 is used as 352's food source, there is no need to sacrifice innocent human infants. On the other hand, SCP-1680 is a collection of identical humanoid entities. Through genetic testing, 1680 has been determined to be an exact replica of Tyler Buchanan, an 8-year-old boy declared missing on the 11th of February 2007. Instances of 1680 are 137 centimeters in height and 38.5 kilograms in mass upon acquisition. Each instance of SCP-1680 believes itself to be Tyler Buchanan and possesses identical memories up to the day of his disappearance. Genetic testing has concluded that each instance is genetically identical to one another and to the original Tyler Buchanan. Each instance of 1680 demonstrates extreme emotional distress when exposed to other copies of 1680. However, due to unknown reason, the request for using 604 and 1680 is currently still pending for approval from the project director. SCP-352 was discovered in a southern Russian town. Reports of an enchanted forest and a witch who had caused several deaths were initially ignored, until reports of the witch being found and captured began to surface. When Foundation agents responded and headed out to investigate, the town was found deserted. Several bodies were found in varying states of decomposition, and blood trails appeared to show many more bodies being dragged into the enchanted forest. The Foundation agents were able to capture 352, but they had suffered major casualties due to SCP-352's attack and exposure to the enzyme. A large amount of hair was recovered as well, and is believed to be the cause of many exposure incidents, with contact being attributed to spider webs or an agent's own hair, and not reported until hallucinations manifested. After the successful capture of 352, this old lady was then put into a containment area that is to remain sealed at all times. No human interaction is allowed with 352. All interaction should be carried out via robot or other remote means. If human interaction become necessary, full hazmat containment protocol should be observed, and full hazmat suit should be worn at all times. In addition, security lines must be attached to all personnel. Should any personnel begin to exhibit erratic behavior, they are to be immediately removed from the containment area via the security lines. Any staff reporting hallucinations after interaction with 352 or her hair are to immediately be placed under quarantine. Any staff working in or around the containment area must submit to random psychological and physical testing. Anyone found to be contaminated will be placed into immediate quarantine. Staff attacked by SCP-352 may only be recovered if they have not been bitten by 352. 352 is to be fed only once a week. Feeding will be discontinued for 1 month if 352 attacks any personnel. Although 352's containment area is always sealed, but one time, SCP-3783-1 instances managed to break in, and two of which had interacted with SCP-352. SCP-3783-1 instances are mutated biological organisms after entering SCP-3783. 3783 is a single-roomed log cabin that is located in the wilderness of Siberia. Inside it is decorated with furs, has one rocking chair, a fireplace, a wardrobe, a chest, and a cauldron. It has two windows on the sides and a single wooden door allowing for entry. There were rumors saying that 3783 is 352's cottage, hence the interaction between 3783-1 instances and 352 was very peaceful and strangely loving. The following transcript is from surveillance footage. Begin log. SCP-352 is sitting at the corner of its containment chamber. After 40 seconds, a vent that led into the chamber suddenly burst open, which two 3783-1 instances crawl out of. Simultaneously, other 3783-1 instances were attacking from Gate A. One instance resembled a gastropod with two arm-like appendages. It quickly moves to the door, and a bulbous sac on its back began to expand and bursts, covering the door with a thick mucus. The second instance was feline and resembled a bearded dragon, which moves towards SCP-352. The instance had in its mouth what appears to be a human fetus, which it places on the floor in front of SCP-352. SCP-352 reaches for the fetus and begins to devour it. SCP-352 then pats the instance's head. The instance and SCP-352 appear to briefly converse before SCP-352 stands and moves towards the instance. SCP-352 kneels down and appears to whisper to the instance. Instance then nods its head and returns into the vent as SCP-352 stands idly while facing the camera for the remainder of the footage. End log. The instance was later found at Provisional Site 78 within SCP-3783's chamber. It was found deceased in front of SCP-3783 and was buried in a clump of dirt. Before we end this video, we are proud to present these incredibly sweet pieces of fan art. A big thank you to all of you. You can now send us your fan art, and we will be more than happy to show off your best art piece in our next video. Check out our description below on how to submit. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Which SCP do you want to see in the next video, and why it is interesting? Let us know in the comment below. We will draw your story and share it with the world. Don't forget to click like, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell. Please share it to your friends if you like this video. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you in the next video. Bye-bye!